Okay, I want to add some additional insight onto this topic, something that maybe you haven't considered yet. Looking at these different methods that people use for selecting a main jet size are all missing something. This is a test I did today to prove what I pretty much already knew, and that the higher the load, the richer the jetting needs to be. Okay? I did an uphill test where the max RPM was reduced at least 10%. So the degrees of the uphill was probably a little bit less than 10 degrees. It's just a 48cc engine. So, testing on the uphill, the number 85 main jet gave less speed at a certain marker along the uphill than the 90 did. And I didn't have any bigger jets to test, but this is sufficient to prove the point. And then on a flat road test, accelerating from one point to another point of a set distance, where the beginning point was crossed at the same RPM each time, keeping the bike in the same gear, the second point being just a little bit beyond where the bike reaches its top RPM. The first, whatever that was, 10 to 20 feet, I was rolling on the throttle, okay? The rest was wide open throttle. And the jet that gave the best, the lowest time of 15.3 seconds was the 82.5. So the difference in the flow area using the needle I did and these two jettings gave a 5.7% difference. It's to say this setup gave 5.7% more fuel than this setup did. So the point here is that depending upon the load, you have different jetting needs. Okay? A dyno is the best of all of these. And a dyno has a set load. Okay? Does that load match what you typically encounter? If you just, if you live on a flat land and you just ride on the street, the highest load situation you're going to have is accelerating with an additional passenger on the bike. Okay. Does that dyno match that load? I'll bet you any damn thing. They just have one setting, or maybe they've got a chart and they choose a setting for the engine size. I don't know, but there's a better way. This sucks. This has too many variables. This also has too many variables. So the range is from flat terrain, hard packed, without a passenger, whether it's a street bike or a dirt bike, to a high load situation. The question for you is, what's a typical high load situation? And have you tried different main jets during that high load situation to find out which one is the best? Or did you only test on flat terrain? This is the uphill at Glen Helen motocross track. Look how steep it is. How many seconds does it take them from the bottom to reach the top? I would guess 5 to 10 seconds. For a completely hot engine to have that extra load, is that long enough for it to cease? I would say if it's lean enough, yes. I'm still talking about two strokes. I don't know what these bikes are, the four stroke, two stroke. I'm just talking about two strokes. So, no matter what your riding is, if your high load situation is long enough for a completely heated up engine to seize, then you have to jet for that high load situation. So this is the high load that I used, the uphill test, okay? I have done many tests on this hill where I live, and it's just the perfect hill for this bike. Just perfect. I couldn't have wanted more, and I just got it by luck. I chose the place where I'm living just because it's a nice beach town. But lucky me, I've got this great hill to test on. And I have noticed, before I broke my cylinder head temperature gauge, this is an air-cooled engine. It would get above 300 degrees temperature, which is no good. A cylinder head should never be above 300. And it's probably because I was jetted down here, okay? If that's something I'd be doing often, yeah, that's something to worry about. So it depends upon what your maximum load situation is, how many seconds you're doing that situation, how often you do it. So this is your range of jetting between flat road and high load. Well, you could just say this is low load, this is high load, okay? If you don't have any high load, you just jet for this. If you have very little low load, you mostly jet over here. So all these other ways of going about it makes me wonder. I don't like any of them. So here's the data, the jet size, the results. So in my case, a good compromise would be using the number 85 jet, because for the acceleration test, that brings it down only 1%. And for the uphill test, that brings it down only 1.5% from the best result. Spark plug color. Oh, that's my pet peeve. I hate that. Go on any motorcycle forum. Every time someone posts a picture of their seized piston and cylinder, ask them, did you jet according to spark plug color? They will say, yes, Poppy, I did. I'm such a good boy, aren't I? No, dumbass, you fucked up. But I've seen pictures of the race teams looking at the spark plug. Oh, there's a lot of things, grasshopper, that you can tell by looking at a spark plug. But jetting's not one of them. Jennings even wrote about it, and his writings are like 40 years old. This is my webpage on the subject. This is the address right here. It talks about different methods of jetting. And the tests I've done absolutely prove you cannot jet by spark plug color. I don't even know why I'm talking about this. I just should just ignore it completely. It's just like talking to a Catholic about the Virgin Mary. I think some people don't like things I teach because it brings a degree of complexity that they don't really want to deal with. Most of the people that like what I bring out are the smart ones. There's some really smart people riding motorcycles. And then the opposite is true. My favorite audience are the smart ones. Anyway, thank you for watching. Take care.